Well, I'm sunk. And just gotten way in over my head. So I guess I'll try to explain this. We live off grid. We live on an acre and a half. This is my property, my backyard. I get to get up in the morning and watch the squirrels and the rabbits. Actually, I think I'm actually getting a pet rabbit, a wild rabbit. It is not scared of me at all. Every morning I come down, I open up the chicken coop and check the charge on the batteries, make sure I don't need to run the generator. That rabbit there to greet me, doesn't run off. And then when I come down in the evening, I check the batteries again to make sure that we got plenty of charge during the day. And I close up the chicken and some feed them, and that rabbit's there. The only time the rabbit isn't there is when Skitty, our cat, follows me down here. She likes to chase that rabbit. It's really nice here. Recently, we had to take Carolyn's son into the city. And I say city like it's a huge city. It's not. It's a good-sized town. And the stress of that was just a lot more than I wanted to deal with. The roundabouts, I hate those. I'm always confused. I feel like, man, when did I get old? I've driven, I don't know when I say this, people think I'm exaggerating. I've driven over 1,000,000 miles in my life. I used to be self-employed. Drove to Minnesota and Iowa, Michigan, Illinois, where else? All over Missouri, Indiana. And I would have to go to different companies every 3 months, so I'd repeat customers. Every 3 months, I'd go to Minnesota. And I tried to schedule the trips as best I could so I can get all my Minnesota trips done in 1 month and then Illinois, but sometimes that didn't work out. We had audits that I had to make special trips to. I had like 5 cars and all of them had over 200,000 miles on them. But now it's like, man, I just want to stay here. I've gotten really burnt out on life. I get comments in the comment section, and I don't even know why people do this. They are lying about their accomplishments in life. And why would you lie about living off-grid? But I get people clearly lying to me. Yeah, I've been living off-grid since 1998, and I've got all this, and they start rattling off some of the stuff they got. And you're reading it, and I get up in the morning and I read my nighttime comments. Usually I'm pretty tired by this. You know, I'm still pretty tired. I'm foggy. And if it's like, hey, Rob, great video, you know, something, I can just heart it and say thanks and move on. But those other ones, I always let them rest because I want to process what they've just said. And usually about an hour later, it occurs to me, that guy's lying. There's no way. And they have said something in the comment that is just completely wrong. It just doesn't work. And you know, of course, you read it the first time, you didn't think about it. But then you're like, solar panels don't do that. You know, I've been living with solar panels for 3 years now. Prior to that, I had solar panels back in 2005, and I tried to put a solar panel together with the little solar cells. I mean, I've had a lot of experience with solar panels. Am I an expert? No, there's people a lot smarter than me. But what these people are clearly saying is wrong. And you're like, why are you exaggerating this? I tell this story a lot, and I'm not going to name any names. I was on a submarine, the USS Georgia, SSBN 729. Now it's an SSGN. They converted it to a guided missiles. We used to be ballistic missiles. It was a Trident submarine. And at the time, I think it still is, I don't know. It was a Trident submarine. It was the biggest in the United States fleet. Now, of course, Russia had bigger submarines, but I don't know. I worked my way through the ranks. I made E5. So I was a petty officer, second class. And I started out as an E1. I think I went to the submarine as an E1. And I struck for my rate, which was a machinist mate. Not a nuclear machinist mate. I was hydraulics and diesel engine. And I remember one time we had this test. We were being tested. They did these tests regularly. And I was a forward auxiliary man. And the forward compartment got hit or something, you know, in the simulation was hit. And all my systems failed, all of them. The Fairwater planes, I had to take manual control of them. I had a diesel engine. Of course, an off-going watch ran the diesel engine, but I still had set up for all that. I had set up the forward compartment for the diesel engine run. What else was there? There was other things. Ventilation was screwed up. Had a high pressure air system. And so I asked for one of the off-going watches to help me out because I was just overbooked. And they simulated that he died. So I was on my own. And I was actually congratulated by the captain. I was just shocked by this, floored by it. I didn't even know he knew my name. I was like, hey, yeah, you saw me once. And he congratulated me that I handled it so well. But I didn't mess anything up. I got a complete score on it. And I'm not bragging. I'm truly not bragging. It was very stressful, very overwhelming, but I'm very proud of that moment. And I got, and at the time I was an E4, and I got Junior Sailor of the Year for that. It was a little award that, you know, you get a special parking spot for a few weeks. I guess it was not year. It was Junior Sailor of the Quarter. That's what it was. So I come home, and I'm still all about submarines. I got out of the Navy, and I'm all about submarines, and I'm trying to brag about it and talk about my adventures. And someone who I respected a lot said, oh, that's nothing. Wait until you're being depth charged at 200 feet by the Japanese Navy. And I said, you're right, sir. You're right. I wasn't. The war that I entered in, the Desert Storm, whatever that was, back in the 90s, was over by the time I did anything. So, I mean, I was just... I like to brag that I ended the Cold War because shortly after... Well, I guess I was in the Navy when the Cold War ended. So, but it was a lot more than just me. But I have not talked about the submarine at all since then. People ask me about it, and this is probably the most I talk about it. I mean, I've told this story several times because I was very proud of it. But I really don't talk about it much. Now, I will admit that we got to go south of the border, and I have all these awards to prove it. I don't have them with me. They're at my mom's house. And we went through the Panama Canal. You know, you go south of the border, and there's this tradition that you have to do all these gross things and walk through muck and, you know, to eat a cherry out of some guy's belly button, and it's, but I got it. I don't know what it's worth. I don't know. I'm more embarrassed by it now than I, because of the man who I respected. Well, after he died, somebody asked me to do some research on him. And so I did. I did a lot of research. Spent probably 6 months looking into this guy. And he joined the Navy, and he was in the Navy for 6 months. Now, he claimed he was in Special Forces. This was before the Navy SEALs. The Special Forces in World War II became the Navy SEALs, but I don't even remember what they were called back then. So I looked him up, and it turned out he'd been in the Navy for only 6 months, never left Washington State, and was a corpsman. A corpsman is a medic. Which, don't get me wrong, very respectful, but he never served on a submarine. I don't know, I was really taken back by that. I'd given up my proud history because I did not do as well as someone else. Someone who actually served in the Navy and protected our freedoms. What did I do? I ran around opening valves and taking manual control of the Fairwater planes. Woo-wee! I mean, that's a big deal, right? I went south of the equator. Oh, don't forget, we went through the Panama Canal. I mean, that's nothing compared to being death charged. And oh, that's frightening. I mean, I even remember after he told me that, I watched Das Boot. It's a movie. German submarine being attacked. And I thought, man, and that guy was really, he really went through it. And then to find out he didn't. It ruined my bragging rights, I guess. I don't know. And I'm just not a big bragger anyways. Or maybe that is what caused me not to brag when, you know, they always say, there's always a faster gun in the West. Well, there was. But I didn't realize the faster guns were a myth. I didn't realize that, but apparently that's what it is. There's nobody faster. They lie. And so it's the same thing as this solar panel thing. They're lying. They don't have what they said, and there's clear indication in this. So I've been asked recently by lots of people, what are my thoughts on this submersible being crushed going to the Titanic with these billionaires on it. And I don't even understand the question. Why are you asking me? Well, you've been on a submarine. You know what it's like. Well, I was on a Navy submarine with 120 people on there. I shared a rack room. I mean, it had 9 racks in it. I mean, I was on a bigger submarine. Now, the first two or three patrols, I slept on the lower level, and we just had a bed on the floor, on the deck. But I eventually got promoted to a rack room, and I didn't even get to go into my division's rack room. I was kind of in the misfits room, and it was sitting right next to the lounge. There was a lounge, and they always had the TV full blast. You could never sleep because of that full blast TV. Now my division, A gang, they were all the way at the end, right next to the machinery tube room. So I don't know. I'm just not a big bragger. So when I'm asked about the submarine, first of all, I've never been in a 5-man submarine. It's called a submersible. It's not really a submarine. Submarine is a big tube, several yards, you know, how many feet is that thing? I forget. I don't remember. It's huge. So these 5 people went down there, and they went through an adventure. They knew what they were getting into, and the drama of all this. I don't even understand the drama. The drama makes no sense to me. First of all, I'm not following it. I mean, I think I've read a headline or two that there was a submersible that sunk going to the Titanic, and I was like, okay. And then all of a sudden, everybody started asking me about it. And I'm like, I don't know. What is this? It's not my adventure. I have nothing to compare it to. That's not like being depth charged at 200 feet. Well, no, I guess not, because you're still alive. These guys are dead. What I would imagine happened was it imploded. And when it did, they instantly vaporized. The pressure was so intense that it created a bunch of heat, and they just instantly vaporized. And so they bubbled to the top. That's about the best I could understand. And that's from what I've been told. I don't know how true that is. But I understand under pressure, things heat up. So I'm not going to compare my experiences to that tragic incident that I'm not even paying attention to. It's night and day. I'm not going to sit here and talk about and over-exaggerate that, oh yeah, we had a flooding one incident one time, and I have water up to my neck, and I'm trying to put in a plug. I'm not going to do that. Now, I will tell you, I was in sub-school in Connecticut, Groton, Connecticut, and we had to go through a trainer, and water is just blasting in on you, and you know you're completely safe. They're going to shut it off. They're not going to let anybody drown. And you're just panicked, and you're trying to put these plugs in and bandit kits, and you're like, you failed. You sunk. So, no. I've not done anything very exciting. I have nothing to report that says, hey, I've been through this experience. I don't know what to tell you. I would suggest, in all seriousness, that you are proud of your accomplishments. There is absolutely no reason to come to an off-grid channel. I mean, think about this, an off-grid channel. I'm not doing anything overly exciting. I'm not doing anything like, you know, going down to see the Titanic. I have a few solar panels and a well. I mean, that some chickens. This isn't like, you know, rocket science or anything. You can Google this stuff and you'll learn how to do it. You can even go to Harbor Freight and pick up the set yourself. It's got instructions on how to do it, I think. So, I mean, it's not too complicated. It's just a matter of investing money and getting it done. So instead of bragging about how great your solar panels are, even though you don't have any, and how great your battery system is, even though you don't have any, why not talk about your real accomplishments and be proud of those? I'm proud of my life. I'm proud that I ran my own business. I'm proud I've been on a submarine. I'm proud that I raised a daughter. And those are good enough. I don't need to be comparing myself to people who died going to see the Titanic. So if you'll click this up next box to take you to a video where I was talking about how I turn my well on now. Oh boy, that's exciting. So I hope I can inspire you to be happy with who you are so you can live your dreams. Thanks for watching.